make sure we've got a nice clear space, the same as every week now. We want a nice clear space. You also need a bench or a chair or a step. Don't use it all the time, just keep it out of the way. When I need it, I'll tell you need it, just drag it over. We'll also need kind of higher ceilings. Obviously, I know that's not possible for everyone, but if you have got low ceilings, be aware that you're riding a little bit of jumping. Your hands might go up, so make sure you don't whack them with anything. A bottle of water is handy, a glass of water. It's quite a sweaty one, so yeah, it's always good to have on hand. Also a towel, I like to have a towel. I can go into it a little bit now. We are going back to our first kind of structure. So if you were here from the start, we did 3 weeks of a 90-second structure. We're going back to that one, okay? So if you were back at the start, you'll probably recognise this as we go. If not, that's fine. I'll explain it before we get into it. Okay, I can see people coming. Also, please share it, okay? This is free, so it's free for everyone. Share it. Anyone can join in. If they like it, they'll come back, okay? Cool. We'll get into the intro. So like I said, this is HIIT, full body workout. We'll work for 90 seconds, 30 seconds off. Each exercise will have, you know, the exercise will have a progression to make it harder and a regression to make it slightly easier. So it will tailor to everyone. You can change if you want either the harder one, the easier one, as you go. Okay, so if you're strong in your legs, go for the progression. If you're weak in your upper body, go for the regression, okay? We'll get into the warm-up. Starting in a press-up position. From this position, we're going to drop down onto our knees, and we're going to stretch through with our arm. We're going to have 5 on each side. Get a nice stretch. Okay, from this, we're going to jump up into the press-up position, jump our legs in, and now these are squat thrusts. We're going to do 5 of these. Okay, next one, another stretch. Lunge up to our elbow. So bring the knee up to the elbow, hold it for a second, and then back down. Again, 5 on each side. Couple more. Okay, last one, press-ups. Just 5 press-ups, you can either do these on your knees or on your toes, chest all the way to the floor, and back up. Well, okay, well done, jump up. That's the upper body warm. We're gonna go to lower body now. Starting with squats, okay? Squat down and back up. If you can, try and get at least parallel. If you can only go a quarter squat, that's fine, okay? We're just going for 5 squats. Keeping our chest looking out. Trying to push through our heels, not coming up onto our tiptoes. Okay, next one, lunges. Big step out and down. We're looking for 2 right angles of our knees. We're going for 5 on each side. Really push off that leading leg to get back to that standing position. Couple more. Okay, last one. Last 2, so we're gonna come with the high knees. So nice and high on your toes. Get the knees nice and high. Again, like the squats, you can only go this high, that's fine. You're just gonna get yourself nice and warm. Nice and light your toes, okay? Now we're gonna go to heel flicks. So from the side, so flick your heels to your bum, nice and light your toes. Gonna be really springy, bouncing on those calves. Okay, a couple more seconds. Okay, get my timer ready. Like I said, we're working for 90 seconds per exercise. It's a range of upper body, lower body, pulse range exercises, okay? Some are placed strategically so it gets you to feel the burn, but it's all good. First one is requiring the bench, and it's a Bulgarian split squat. So we're going to put our back leg on to your bench, your chair, your sofa, and you're just going to squat down, okay? So squat down, try and get the knee closest to the floor. You don't want to bang it on the floor. Again, like the squat, you can only go this far, that's okay. There is a regression for this one. The progression is to go down and jump off that leading leg, okay? That's the progression to make it harder. The regression is box squat, okay? So if you're struggling to work on one leg, squat down onto your chair, step, and back up again. Again, 90 seconds of work. Because this is single leg, we'll do 5 on one leg, 5 on the other leg. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. So down and up. It might take a couple of seconds to get your you know, your spacing right, but once you're in, you should be able to crack out 5, change leg, other side, okay? Chest nice and upright. Change sides up to 5. The progression, I'll go again, is the jump, okay? A little bit more balance required. You're going to be really explosive off this leading leg. 5 on each side, and swap. Super explosive. 5 on each side, and swap. The regression, to make it easier, like I said, is the box squat. So squat down to the box. As soon as your bum touches, come back up again, okay? You work with both legs, so you make it slightly easier. You can also have a little bit of rest while you're down here. Come back up again, okay? Take a second pause, come back up. Got 20 seconds to go. If you're still going, that's fantastic, okay? It's our first 90 second exercise. Remember, swap legs up for 5 sets. You have 7 seconds to go. 3, 2, 1. Well done. Okay, so that's 90 seconds. We'll take 30 seconds off. Next one is another leg exercise, a bit more explosive. You can't leave the bench. It's a broad jump out, okay? So you're going to squat down, jump out as far as you can, little couple of sets back, squat down, jump out as far as you can, okay? Be aware of things around you. You might have to go the other side if you've got more space sideways rather than forwards. Also, if you've got no shoes on like these, make sure you don't step over. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Got another 90 seconds. So it's deep squat down, jump out. A couple of side steps back, deep squat down, jump out. Nice and explosive. Make sure you bend your knees from the landing, okay? The progression and regression for this one is as far as you can go. So progression is as far as you can go and back without skidding. Progression, if you only jump that far, that's fine, okay? We're going for 90 seconds, for 30 seconds, and we've got a minute to go. So nice and explosive out and up. Land on 2. Again, try not to slip. Probably should have washed some trainers. Well, we are halfway through, you have 40 seconds to go. And back we go. If you start to feel your legs, use your arms as well. Use your arms to get that momentum out. And back. You have 25 seconds to go. Remember, the regression is as far as you can go. If you're going to jump this far, that's fine. Just make sure you get that deep sweat in first. If you want to challenge yourself, go as far as you can. We have 10 seconds to go. You can get a couple more jumps in. 5. And done. Okay. Another 30 second rest. Next one is burpees. Actually, the 180 degree burpees. So, like a normal burpee, we're going to go down to that pressing position, jump your legs back in. A normal burpee, we jump straight up. This variation, we jump up, 180 turns, so we're facing the other way, okay? So we go down, jump, and turn. Okay, in 3, 2, 1, Good, so down into that burpee, 180 turn, other way, okay? Make sure that jump, nice and explosive. Give you enough time to turn in the air. Okay, your progression. That's too tough. Again, use your knee-high surface. Put your hands here, jump in, and up, okay? So make it slightly easier, so hands down, in, and up. So there's no turn, but it's slightly easier. We are 40 seconds in, got 50 to go. And turn. Make sure that jump is nice and explosive. If that's too easy, you better press up in. Go down, press up, in, and turn. So down, press up, in, and jump. We have 25 seconds to go. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the normal exercise. The last 15 seconds now. Your legs should be burning. 10 seconds to go. 5 seconds to go, you get one more in. Okay, well done. Grab a drink if you need one. We're going to have a 30 second rest. Okay, next one. You got legs again. It's a glute bridge march. So, hands out to the side. We're going to come up into the glute bridge. And we're going to march our legs towards us, okay? So knee into your chest, keeping those hips high the whole time. 3, 2, 1, got another 90 seconds. So keep that hips on the floor the whole time. You march, knee into your chest. Alternate legs. Your glutes should be in this high position the whole time, constantly working. Okay, if that's too hard, you can just progress to a glute bridge. Start at the bottom, press to the top, back down, okay? So you get that rest at the bottom. This is your regression to make it easier. Okay, if you're finding the original glute bridge too easy, do single leg, okay? So 3 reps on one leg, change leg, okay, 3 reps. And change. You have 30 seconds to go. We're going back to the glute bridge march. Keep going, keep those hips off the floor. 20 seconds to go. Remember, you can always go to the glute bridge to really burn out now. We have 10 seconds to go. Keep going. 5 seconds. And done. Okay. Another 30 second rest. Next up is press ups. We're going to have a body now. Obviously, normal press ups on your toes, chest to the floor, press up. If that's too hard, in a normal press up position, drop straight down to your knees and then press, okay? Make sure you're not really bent over like this. You're still in that nice angle to press. Okay, 30 seconds to go. 30 seconds are done. 90 seconds, go. Press up. Anyone not take a break? Remember, progression, just drop onto the knees and press. If you're a machine, you're still going, you want a progression. My progression is just go as fast as you can go. Keep the proper form, but really bust them out, lower wrist at the top. That's the progression, okay? Just really burn out. We are halfway through already. If you're starting to struggle, take a little rest at the top. Press a little rest at the top. Press. If you're really struggling, take 3 seconds and then get into it. 30 seconds to go. Keep going. We'll be on. We are 20 seconds to go. If anyone's still going, I'll be impressed. Remember the regression, you can always go down to it. The last couple, you're still going to do that burn in your chest. We have 5 seconds to go now. And we're done. Okay, 30 seconds rest. Next one is a hold, okay? So we're just going to be holding position. It's a press-up hold, okay? A little bit mean of me. We're going to go from the press-ups straight to the press-up hold. This is our press-up hold, okay? It may not look hard after those press-ups and after we get into 1:90, shoulders, your chest, everything's going to be burning. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Into that position. Keep everything tight, core tight, chest tight, shoulders tight. Okay, your regression, just like the press ups, is to drop down onto your knees. It's gonna take some of the load off, it's gonna make it easier. That's regression. The progression to make that a bit harder is to really find that hard spot. So if you unlock your elbows and go down, you're starting to burn a lot more. That's what I mean by the hard spot, okay? So you find it easy, go down, find that hard spot, hold that position, okay? Halfway through. Make sure your hips haven't dropped quite to the floor and they're not in the air. Try and keep a nice straight body. Head out, chest up. Boy on. 30 seconds to go. Hold that position. Starting to burn now. We have 20 seconds to go. Hope you're still holding it. 10 seconds to go. And 3, 2, 1, well done. Okay, now 30 second rest. Okay, last one is another hold, okay? Lower body hold this time, it is a squat hold, okay? So, at least parallel, looking out, 90 seconds on those glutes and on those thighs. 3, 2, 1, go. As you're comfortable, you're gonna be like this for a while. Exactly the same progressions and regressions, okay? So the progression is to find that hard spot. You might find this by going a little bit lower, a little bit higher. Where it burns, try and stay there as long as possible, okay? The regression, hands on your thighs, okay? So if you get hands on your thighs, it's really gonna take some of the load off. Another regression is to come up, 5 seconds, shake your legs out, and then get back into it, okay? This is the last exercise we do before our abs. So a large little bit of leg before we do before our abs. So really put the work in now. Over halfway through. Make sure your chest is looking out and it's not really bent over like so. Try and keep it up as much as possible. 30 seconds to go. Don't move now. Last 15 seconds. Hold it. I know your legs will be burning. 10 seconds to go. And 5. And come up, well done. Okay. That's the HIIT done. We now go on to the abs, which I forgot to mention. We're going to be working for a 2 minute circuit, having a little rest and then going again, so it's only 5 minutes of abs. What we've got, we have a side plank on the right to start off with. So, feet in the air, nice straight body position, arm in the air. That's number one. Number two is the other side, so on the left. So you work the right, you're going to work the left, same position. Next one is Russian twist, so feet off the floor, twisting the other side. Last one is heel taps on the floor, upper back and head off the floor, tap each heel as you go. Okay. 2 minutes of work, 3, 2, 1, go. Starting with right side plank. Make sure your body's nice and straight, it's not bent. The progression is, arm comes through, open the body up. So that's the progression. So the arm comes through, open the body up. If it's too hard, drop down onto one knee and hold it. Again, it's going to take some of the load off. Make sure your hip is off the floor. We have 3 seconds to go. Other side. Exactly the same exercise. Exactly the same progressions and regressions. You find it easy, come through, open the body up. Find it hard, drop down onto one knee. We have 10 seconds to go. Hold it nice and tight. Well done. Next one, no rest, Russian twist. Feet off the floor. You're turning the trunk either side. You find that too easy, add a punch in as you go across. It's gonna make you stabilize a little bit more. You find that too hard, rest your feet on the floor. It'll make you more stable. And we've done last one, last 30 seconds, heel taps. Up, back off the floor, tap into the heel. You make it harder, really slow down and squeeze either side, okay? Really squeeze your abs. You want to make it easier, you can take a little rest and then get back into it. We have 10 seconds to go. And 3, 2, 1. Okay. We'll take 30 seconds rest. We'll get to that one more time. So grab a drink if you want one. Okay, exactly the same exercises, same timings, same regressions and regressions, okay? So you all know if you want to go straight into those progressions, you've just seen them, what I just showed you. Okay. Last 2 minutes for our cool down. 3, 2, 1. Go, start with the side plank on the right. Remember, push yourself the last 2 minutes. You can do that progression, do it. If you've been doing the regressions all day, try and do our normal one. Really push yourself. If you're like me and you're burnt out, just hold the normal pose. We'll be on. We have 5 seconds to go. Okay, swap sides. 90 seconds of work to go. We are on, 45 seconds, 15 seconds to go. Hold it, keep it nice and tight. Three seconds to go. Okay, straight into the Russian twist. Feet off the floor if you can. I keep my feet on the floor, this is the regression. Fifteen seconds to go. Five to go. Last one, heel taps. Last 30 seconds of work. Make sure you don't just run on the floor, make sure your chest, sorry, upper back and head are off the floor. We have 10 seconds to go. And 3, 2, 1, and you're done. Okay. Well done, grab a drink. We'll do our cool down and then we're all done. Okay, so stretches. We'll start at the top. So shoulder stretch, arm across your body. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. A little bit of a revisit on what we did for the first couple of weeks. Next week we're going to mix it up again. But what you've already seen, keep it fresh for you. Next one, triceps on above your head. Like I said at the start, please like it, comment. Any questions, let me know and I'll reply to you in the comments afterwards. If you think it's a stupid question, just still fire it through to me. I'll try my best to answer it. Okay, next one is side bend. Nice wide stance, can stretch up to the side. Again, we do classes every week, so please check them out if you haven't seen them already. So we've got box fit on Mondays, legs, bums, and tongues Tuesday, stretch and flex of Andy on a Wednesday. Obviously my class today and then shape and move tomorrow with Tom. Next one, quads. Quite leg heavy today, so gonna get a nice stretch in our quads. Okay, have a leg. After this we've got a couple more. Okay, next one, got our groin, big step out, over to the side. Other side. Okay, last one, smaller stance. You're gonna go, touch your right foot again. If you can only touch your legs, that's fine. Over to the left. And now in the middle, nice good stretch. Okay, shake your arms out, shake your legs out. Like I said, any comments, feedback, let me know. In the meantime, stay safe, stay active, and stay healthy.